When viewing Luffy in a narrative like One Piece, it is very easy to miss the forest for the trees. Luffy isn't trying to be a hero. He's a pirate and therefore is an enemy of the world he inhabits. What defines Luffy as a complete anomaly within his pursuit of a pirate's life is his moral foundation, which has been fundamentally instituted through the significant inspiration of Shanks. Through his connection with Ace and Sabo, Luffy discovered the robust bond of friendship and family, in contrast to the crushing solitude of loneliness that he understood all too well. And through the cultivation of a multitude of positive influences, situations of extreme suffering, and a profound will to accomplish his dreams at all cost, Luffy sets out on an adventure with the mindset to become the freest man in the world. The idea of freedom is different for everybody. For someone like Blackbeard, it means absolute anarchy and the abolishment of public order. In Akainu's case, he believes that too much freedom leads to destruction and tries to constrict individuals. What's great about Luffy is that he is the answer to this moral dilemma. Luffy is balance. Luffy believes that kingdoms, marines, and the government should exist for the people. A certain amount of order is necessary for freedom. Luffy definitely isn't a genius, but he isn't an idiot either. I would categorize Luffy as someone who disregards the consequences of his actions and follows his heart. And the undertones of the sentiments are his love for his friends and his dream to be free. It's this same balance with Luffy's ideology and the shifting tides of fate that continue to oppose his destiny to challenge the course of the world. There are several moments in Alabasta and the East Blue that cement Luffy as a nuanced and fully realized character. The most iconic of these situations is Luffy's absolute refusal to hear Nami's checkered past, contrasted with his complete trust in her as a friend and his resolve to help her out without question. It clearly sets the stage for where Luffy's ideals and values lay, and how they are motivated to support those he cares about. This concept is doubled down when he climbs the mountain at Drum King Island, and my god, that was excruciating. And my personal favorite moment is when Luffy tells Vivi that she can depend on them. In each of these circumstances, Luffy wasn't weighing the pros and cons of each situation. He wasn't masterminding a plan that would inevitably succeed. He was just doing what he thought was right in the moment and acted upon that feeling. This is the micro level of freedom that Luffy perpetuates. Now let's talk about the macro. This macro level sentiment of freedom is highlighted in Skypiea. Ironically, Skypiea is a microcosm of the One Piece world. Enel symbolically represents God, and Luffy is someone who refuses to be bound by a higher power. Their devil fruits respectively exemplify this, portraying how Luffy, and by extension the D-Clan, is the natural enemy of God and the Celestial Dragons. Later on, Law's backstory solidifies this concept, specifically with his conversation with Corazon, who states that those who share the name D are always conflicting with those in higher positions. The Storm of D will always unleash chaos. And this is unequivocally true, because in each arc, Luffy brings destruction, but the caveat is that it leads to the creation of a better society. In contrast, someone like Blackbeard causes destruction and it leads to more destruction. Even Garp, who has a very important position in the Marines, technically created destruction in the form of Dragon and Luffy. Those of the D-Clan are often referred as devils, so of course they are going to be the enemies of God. And just like Skypiea, Dressrosa also plays a pivotal role in defining the overarching themes of One Piece. Doflamingo was born a celestial dragon, those who literally refer to themselves as gods. Through his deceptive and violent revolution, Doflamingo became the false king of Dressrosa, just as the Celestial Dragons became the false gods of the One Piece world. Doflamingo maintained his superiority complex because that's how he thought a leader, a god, a king should rule. But in his last panel where he fights Luffy, his perception is completely obliterated. Luffy smashes Doflamingo's glasses, shattering the lens he viewed the world through, and simultaneously freeing the citizens of Dressrosa from the false concept of God that Doflamingo was imposing on them. Luffy perpetuates that his idea of freedom doesn't come from authoritarian regimes, nor is it built upon by anarchy. Liberty at the expense of another's autonomy isn't true freedom. Liberty is about equality, and that's why Luffy sees people on a leveled playing field, and that's why he is undoubtedly the freest man on the sea.